Welcome to first chapter of FPDF tutorial series. This series is about how to generate PDF file in PHP. PDF generation in PHP gave a web-based application abilities to represent a printable, fixed layout document to millimeter precision. Such as printable invoices, printable reports, printable manifests, and other printable documents. The downside is, we cannot alter the produced document and it depends on browser's PDF plugins. In this chapter, I'm going to show you how to make a PDF invoice in PHP using FPDF class. You can download FPDF library package, then extract its content to your Hite docs directory. This package contains FPDF PHP library, example tutorials, and documentation. FPDF has many methods to make and manipulate PDF content, as you can see in its documentation. But in this chapter, I'm going to explain only the most basic functions necessary to build a PDF page. In this example, I am going to use portrait, A4 size paper with millimeter measurement unit. Here's the size detail of the A4 paper. First, we create an FPDF object with its parameter. Next, add a page using addPage method. Here you can also define size and orientation for each page, but that's optional. Then using setFont method, we set the font to Arial, bold, and 14 point size. Now we're going to fill the PDF with something. But first, let me explain how it works. PDF contents is written in cells. Imagine cell as a container. You can only put text in cell, and each cell has its own properties such as width, height, border, and so on. Cells are stacked horizontally one after another, from left to right, and end with a cell, which defined as an end of line, imagine an enter button. The next cell after end of line cell is put below the cells, just like pressing enter button when you are typing. First parameter is width in millimeter. Second is height. Third is text content. Fourth is border, 0 means no border, 1 means all border. Fifth is new line, set to 1 to define new line. Sixth is align, it is optional. There are two things to keep in mind. First, do not echo or output anything, including a single line or space. Because it will damage the generated PDF, rendering it unreadable. Second, after we put our contents, in the last line of script, we need to call output method to generate PDF file and send it to client. Make sure every line's total width doesn't exceed writable horizontal. Now let's focus on the code, I'll fast forward it a bit. Finally, clear unnecessary borders. This concludes this chapter of tutorial. Thank you for watching. See you in the next chapter.